is Shut Up Sipple. Two questions for you, two for Sip. Win and the bagels are yours. Lose, well, you don't want to lose.
You lost Monday, you lost Wednesday, you're a loser.
Shut Up Sipple, weekday mornings at 7:30, brought to you by Bagels and Joe. This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown, Vershawn Jackson.
Terrell Farley. Defending Terrell Farley, who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakoven.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
Yeah, Bak, I like that intro. You were just switching it up. LSU in the building. That's how we do it, Bak. Okay, Bak. Now you starting to do a little something on this Meltdown Monday. Shout out to a couple people. I got to get this out the way. Shout out to Kenny Wilson, little bro. Rest easy. Passed away, 37 years old. Here in Lincoln. I think the funeral is going to be Saturday in Kansas. So shout out to him and his family. Special prayers. If you don't know, Kenny Wilson played JUCO transfer, played for the University of Nebraska. So definitely keep him in your prayers. If you hit him on Facebook or his family, let them know, you know, because Kenny Wilson did pass away April 4th. And another friend of mine, golly, dude, we've got to make sure that, you know, you got loved ones, man. Make sure just say hi. You don't know when the last day is. Now here, Pensick, Cole Pensick. Why does that name sound familiar? Well, son was the center when I was coaching and then recruiting for the University of Nebraska with Bo Pelini. And he passed away in a car accident here in the last, I think, 6-8 months. Mom passed away, which is grandmother. And now dad, who I consider a really good friend from a different era of Nebraska football. He used to tell me all the time he hated tight ends. He hates me because we used to cut him. And even though I didn't play against him, he still had a disdain for me because I was a tight end. But he also loved me as well. And so we lost older Pensick as well. I think last week, I think his funeral was Saturday as well. So if you know the Pensicks, please shoot them just some gratitude, shoot them some love their way. That family is man, to lose a son, a grandmother, a mother, a grandson, a father. I mean, we can't even put the words into. So I wanted to make sure that you guys, the Husker fans, knew about that, and you can support those families. Kenny Wilson, go on Facebook, and I think you can get in touch with his sister. I am interested in, I'm interested. Hey, Terrell.
Yeah.
Love you, buddy.
All right. Love you too, guy.
I just wanted to let you know that. Bak, love you too, man.
I love you guys too.
Yeah. Just on the show though. After the show's over, I don't anymore.
No.
I was just kidding. You're talking about a live ball, then snatch it away. But no, you know, hug your loved ones while you can, man. You don't, you never know. So what are we talking about today? Cause I got some stuff in store. But I'm gonna open the door up for you guys so you don't think that I'm just stealing the show. So Bak, you can start this. What do you have?
Well, today is tax day. Nobody cares.
Did you get an extension today?
Yeah.
Is today tax day?
Today's tax day, I think.
I thought it was 18th, April 18th.
I think it's today, the 15th.
Oh boy. You guys didn't get your did you get your taxes done?
No.
Oh, did you get an extension?
I got some I got people handling my taxes. So
get your taxes done. They said the tax people are about to be like the feds now. You know what I'm saying? You mess up, it's on and popping. Trust me, I know. Tax day. What else?
Well, Nebraska did pick up a few commitments over the weekend. I think that was probably the most interesting thing if you're a Husker fan. Bryson Hayes, a speed wide receiver from Kansas, another one of those kind of track guys looking to convert that track speed to the football field. And then Jackson Carpenter, of course, son of Tim Carpenter, who plays at Lincoln Southwest, also committed, maybe a receiver as well. So a big weekend for the receiving room, or maybe we'll see what Jackson Carpenter ends up doing at Nebraska, you know, kind of listed as an athlete, but two pickups for Nebraska. Now they have five total commitments for the 2025 class, four of them being in state.
Yeah.
But the interesting thing is if you look, you know, depending on what rankings you look at, there's still some of the bigger fish in the state of Nebraska still to get. So interesting.
Who are the bigger fish in the state of Nebraska that we don't have?
That linebacker.
Yeah, that's the biggest one.
Well, that's Christian one. Jones. Who's the rest?
Let me look it up, make sure I get this right here.
I don't know too many big fish.
Yeah, but there Nebraska. Are...
Musket at Nebraska. Muskets?
Yeah.
I know the linebacker. I know that's got to be a musket, but then what?
And he's got offers from, I mean, he's taking visits to USC and all. I mean, so it's going to be tough there. Let me look at the state rankings here. So Christian Jones is the linebacker from Westside that we're talking about. You know, a top 200 type kid. Chase Lofton, the tight end from Millard South, is kind of the other big fish that I was referring to. And then Nebraska does have Tyson Terry, Jackson Carpenter. Pierce Mooberry is one that leaning toward Nebraska, it seems, at this point. They also have Caden Vermas and Connor Booth.
Mm. Let me see that. Let me peek at this real quick. Someone's just gonna peek because something's not. Yeah, here. Look at that. We'll talk about it later. Am I drinking coffee? Is this coffee?
I think that's coffee.
You put cream in coffee?
I don't drink coffee.
People that drink coffee, do you drink it black? Do you drink it with cream? Do you drink it super sweet? How do you drink coffee? Oh, somebody, one of those.
Yeah, there's some comment I got to delete.
Well, yeah, get me. Why? I wanted to read it. Was it a good one?
It's just spam.
Oh, it's spam.
On YouTube or something. I don't know.
Yeah, you're going to stop all that spam on YouTube from Ghana. We don't answer things from Ghana. You don't even know. It's soccer is soccer and football is soccer in Ghana. You saw it? Mm-hmm. Okay, good. We'll talk about that next segment. Yeah, we got to get off the air. To talk about what I just saw, we got, is that nine commits or is that nine?
This is just the top nine in the state, according to 24/7 Sports.
Out of that, we got how many commits?
Right now, we have four out of the state of Nebraska. Mm. Five total with the Kansas.
Those are the top receiver too. Guys in Nebraska.
Yes.
Coming out for 2025.
Yep.
Can you read their bios for the people?
Again, this is according to 24/7 Sports. Each site will have a bit of a different ranking, but the consistent number one is Christian Jones. Linebacker out of Westside, nationally ranked 192nd on here. Chase Lofton, the tight end out of Millard South, he goes 6'6", 215. He's ranked second, according to 24/7. Tyson Terry, again, who is a Nebraska commit on the defensive line, 6'2", 279 out of Omaha North. Jackson Carpenter, who just committed over the weekend, 6'2", 185 athlete, ranked fourth here, and he plays at Southwest here in Lincoln. Pierce Mooberry ranked fifth. He has not committed yet. He's at Millard North, 6'4", 200 pounds, and considered Nebraska lean. Reeming Zebert out of Springfield, playing at Platteview, is a tight end, 6'6", 210, ranked number sixth. Caden Vermas, who's Nebraska's longest commit, I believe, in the class, 6'1", 190 safety, plays at Millard North. Another commit from Nebraska, Connor Booth from Bishop Newman, an athlete, 6'1", 212. And then Casey Popish is also on the top 10 here for the state of Nebraska, according to 24/7 Sports.
Is he committed?
It looks like, I believe he's committed to
NIU or Northern Illinois.
Northern Illinois, yeah.
Not one.
And he's 6'4", tight end.
Where?
230, plays Papillion La Vista South.
Nuh-uh. 1-1. Where? Let me see.
No, we'll talk about it later.
Okay, cool.
We're
talking in codes right now. We can't give up what we're going to have for next segment. So we gotta make sure we come together before we let the cat out the bag, right? Okay.
I've noticed the theme.
No, just stop. Don't you start.
Okay.
Bok, don't do it. Okay. Save it.
Okay.
Save it for next segment. It'll be more interesting next segment because more people will be like, yeah, uh-oh, the captain show's getting ready to release some breaking information. Now it's just going to be us pointing something out. How about that? We're going to point something out that doesn't look right. Right? It looks like it's a square and you're trying to put it in a triangle. It doesn't work. It doesn't fit that way. Is that pretty good analogy on that? I mean, at some point, come on, you talking not how many guys in a class? 22, 23?
Yeah.
Okay. How many linemen in that list?
For Nebraska's commit list or just the Nebraska in the state?
That list that you just read off of, how many offensive linemen is on that list?
Not any.
Oh, see, that's scary. That's scary that you got the top 9, 10 guys in the state and not one of them's a lineman. Not one.
Tyson Terry is defensive line, but.
Tyson Terry's defensive line.
280.
And he could flop over to the other side as well.
Yeah.
Because he's growing like a weed right now. But I'm saying when you look at that list, where are the offensive linemen? I don't know what's going on. I get it. You got a lot of you got a lot of scholarships. You got to make sure you take care of home first. But doggone it, man, it starts up front. And that's scary to think that we don't have an offensive lineman early in this class that's already committed.
Yeah.
You got a D lineman, but you have no offensive lineman. I think we gotta make sure that we shore up and we take care of Dylan Riola, we take care of Dan Kalen, we take care of Heinrich Hardberg, that we do a better job of protecting those guys, and you gotta get the lineman up front. Period. So, you gotta always be developing and you gotta always be recruiting.
I think the more we see Dylan Riola and the more he plays, the more offensive line guys will come because they see him playing as a freshman. It gives them a shot to play as a freshman, especially the top guys. So, he's going to do a little recruiting himself. So I think the more he plays during the season, the better reaction we'll get from recruits that want to come in and contribute early.
Well, I think Nebraska, too, I think I'm impressed by their offensive line depth. I know it's taken a couple of years, but Donovan Rawls, I think, got that thing, in a spot that, there's a few guys you could probably rotate in and out and not mix it up. But a few of them are seniors. So, definitely lasts for so long and you want senior leaders up there. But I think as far as for this year goes, at least I'm excited for the offensive line to finally have some depth where you might have. Some quality starter type guys not make the cut as far as starting.
Good to have depth, but I want to see you push them off the ball. We gotta get an identity. Are we gonna be a passing team? Are we gonna be a rushing team? Can we open the holes for the running back? It's just so much stuff. Can they block for Dylan Riola? I mean, we could talk this talk all day, Bob, but until they play another team, I have to see it through that lens, not through them playing with each other, because they do this every day. Week in, week out, I got to see what they do against other schools, other teams, or how they scheme this thing, because you can only do so much against yourself when you practice against teammates that you practice against for 2-3 years. So, either you're going to win or you're going to lose. That's it.
I get that part, but you know if a guy is – I think by watching practice, if a guy is it or not.
Yeah, I'm just saying on the offensive line
Isaiah
side.
Isaiah Nair, he is it. He is it. You can't tell me that you can't go watch him at practice and be like, I don't know. Let's watch him in game time. He's killing them right now.
Hey.
He's killing them. Dylan is killing them right now.
That could tell you two things. Either he's that good or the DBs aren't that good. So,
we talked all of those stuff about how good our defense was last year. Remember?
Yeah. So
what are you talking about? The DBs ain't that good. We got returning.
If
guys.
You say he out there killing them, VJ, I'm just saying. Is he that good?
Well, you got to dominate the guys in front of you.
Yeah.
Well, so who was the guys that was dominating that when we played?
Nobody dominated.
That's a lie.
Y'all got dominated.
That's what I'm saying. Why don't you be honest?
Y'all got dominated.
That's a lie.
Okay.
That's a lie. You remember the Oklahoma?
You want to give it a round right quick?
Oh, man, let's go. You ain't looking. You look like you're about 180.
Hey, don't worry about this.
Ain't nothing between me and you but space and opportunity.
Well, let's move these chairs.
Well, we'll wait until the break. So that, you know, once we got Band-Aids on, they wonder what happened.
Let's give it to them.
We don't want
to
be, no.
Let's give it
no
to them.
Violence on the radio. Fastest 2 hours on your march. Get set. Go. We'll be right back. 93.7 The Ticket is the captain show. I'm with
the black shirt.
And
by
power.
By
power.
Bauer.
Infrastructure.
Bauer.
I say underground.
Moran.
Excavating.
Hey man, fastest 2 hours in radio on the march is gone already. We'll see you in a minute. We might have some information. You never know. Holla.
Tanner's Bar and Grill is the perfect place to watch your favorite MLB teams this spring and summer, as well as Nebraska baseball. Enjoy Tanner's delicious hamburgers, chicken lips, and daily specials, and wash it down with one of their tons of options of beers. You'll never have an issue finding the game, as there are TVs everywhere throughout the space. So get in early and grab your spot and settle in for an afternoon or evening of baseball at Tanner's Bar and Grill, 30th and Yankee Hill.
Are you looking to get into the electrical construction industry or wanting a new scene? The electrical workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
Several irrigation contractors in Lincoln go out of business every year, leaving sprinkler system orphans begging for service. The folks at Judson Irrigation shed a tear for these little fellas. They've been coddling these orphans for more than 40 years. From redesign, repairing, replacing, and restoring, remember the Judson Irrigation Orphanage.
Call the Judson Irrigation Orphanage, 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
Constructors is now hiring for all positions, with laborers starting at $23 and up based on experience. Constructors has immediate job openings for laborers, mechanics, bridge builders, operators, and drivers. Start your new career today. Constructors offers great pay, health, dental, and vision insurance, paid time off, paid holidays, and so much more. Join the crew today and be a part of Nebraska's oldest paving company dating back to 1908. For a complete list of openings and to apply online, visit constructorslincoln.com.
Houses? They're expensive. And once you buy one, you're kind of stuck with it for a while. You need to make sure you get your best house for the best price. You need Ben Bleicher and his team of pros at Professional Realty Group. They'll take the time to figure out what's important for you in your dream home, and they have the expertise to find the hidden issues that could surprise you after the sale. That's professional knowledge, proactive service. We call that potential. Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Service Ambassador. Find more online at prg-ne.com.
The dangers of secondhand smoke are well known, but what about secondhand aerosol, which is created when using e-cigarettes? Science already shows a secondhand aerosol can contain nicotine, heavy metals, and cancer-causing agents. Eliminating exposure to secondhand aerosol is an important step to keeping everyone safe. Breathe easier knowing the facts.
For help quitting, call the Nebraska Tobacco Quit Line. 1-800-QUIT-NOW. 1-800-784-8669. Paid for by Tobacco Free Nebraska. Aired with the Nebraska Broadcasters Association and this station.
Perch Merch is your one-stop shop for all your printing and promotional needs in Lincoln, Nebraska. They specialize in screen printing, embroidery, vehicle wraps, window wraps, print collateral, promotional products, and signage. At Perch Merch, they are committed to delivering high-quality products and exceptional customer service. Their experienced team of designers and printing professionals will work with you every step of the way to ensure that your vision is realized. Call for a quote today at 402-217-5212 or go to perch-merch.com.
At Southeast Community College, community is our middle name. Our continuing education classes offer personal interest, traffic safety and licensing, online learning, and adult education classes across Southeast Nebraska or online in your own home. Learn to ride a motorcycle, how to start a small business, how to dance, or take a course to advance in your current career path. See the full schedule of continuing education classes online at southeast.edu/continuing. SCC, your path to possible.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, mainly sunny skies and breezy conditions to start off. Then a chance of showers as late. See a high around 83. 63. Tonight, showers and storms likely, some of which could be severe, with a sea low near 63. And tomorrow, more showers, potentially storms likely, the high around 73. I'm meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Problem gambling can destroy an individual's finances, relationships, physical, and mental health. If you or a loved one are struggling with addiction, contact Choices Treatment Center's 24-hour helpline at 402-476-2300. That's 402-476-2300.
Whether you're looking for a place to stay for a concert at PBA, a Nebraska home game, or just a night on the town, the Courtyard Lincoln Downtown Haymarket is the place for you. Enjoy an evening at one of many restaurants or bars within a short walking distance. Business travelers at the hotel will enjoy free high-speed internet access, a 24-hour business center, and large in-room workstations. And check out the Bistro, where you'll enjoy healthier food and beverage options, as well as high-tech conveniences. Book your room today at the Courtyard Lincoln Downtown Haymarket.
Empower a child today with the Teammates Mentoring Program. Hope is only a conversation away when you choose to share your talent, time, and heart with a child. Together, you can build a relationship based on strengths and chart a brighter future, 1 week at a time. Find out how you can be a mentor by visiting LincolnTeammates.org. Become what you needed as a kid by joining the Teammates Mentoring Program today.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer. On 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Da, 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 da. Man, you're trying all kinds of stuff, right? Get your mind right. Give me the, what's he say his name was? Bryson Mays?
Bryson Hayes is the speedy wide receiver from Kansas who committed to Nebraska over the weekend.
What's speedy?
He's got track speed. I look up in his scouting report here.
M-A-I-Z-E?
Yeah.
Really?
Bryson Hayes.
Hayes.
H-A-Y-E-S. But the reason why I thought he's from Mays, Kansas, is why.
Oh, 24-7.
Bryson Hayes.
Highlights. You want to watch the highlights of Bryson Hayes. So we know what we're getting here.
Alan True wrote this on him again in 24/7 Sports. Brings track speed to the football field, takes the top off a defense, and accelerates past defenders on go balls, but can also take short balls and outrun defenses. Big play guy, but want to see him continue to show the whole route tree. Also needs to add weight and get stronger, but is lightning in a bottle and should have a chance to help his college team on special teams as well.
Right away?
Yeah, that's what he says with that type of speed, 5'11", 180.
And he is, well, he'll be a junior or he'll be a senior? He'll be a senior, right?
He'll be a senior because, yeah, it's class 2025.
Yeah, I gotta look him up. I absolutely have to look him up because I could have swore this kid might have a little jiggle to the wiggle. He might have a little X button, meaning he might be able to do some things. You put you in the mind of the Wes Welkers, you know, all those type of receivers that play for New England. What was the guy that played for the Rams? What was his name?
A speed receiver for the Rams? Yeah. Tavon Austin?
Connor Cup? Coop Cup?
Oh, yeah, Cooper Cup.
Cooper Cup.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, he's little.
Yeah.
Homeboy's little.
He had 60 receptions for 962 and 10 last year. 10 touchdowns. That's pretty good numbers.
So give me the stats again.
60 receptions, 962 yards, and 10 touchdowns receiving.
He can catch a little screen. He got some X button now. He got some. Hey. Homeboy got some speed. They're running that little X. I mean, I haven't seen any jiggle. I just see top end speed right now. And they love running that wide receiver kind of, then they run a jet with him. Okay.
When he's the first commit outside of the state of Nebraska again. So I think that's kind of interesting. And for what it's worth, it's like the old days is why I like the commitment because he's a good player out of Kansas and Nebraska goes and takes him. Kansas and Kansas State offered him, but Iowa State and Tulsa, the other teams to offer him, but Nebraska has got him as of now.
Really? I can't tell you I like him. I think he's a heck of an athlete. Ooh. Okay. I mean, you don't know what they're going to develop into, and you don't know. He's still got growing to do, so hopefully he can grow into what he needs to grow into to help us out.
Well, and for what it's worth, too, if you look at Kansas, he's ranked eighth in the state of Kansas, so it's not like they took Nebraska took the Kansas's top guy.
Who's Kansas guy? Who's their top guy?
But they've got six guys ranked as four stars in the state of Kansas, including a five star and Andrew Babalolola. And you wanted to talk about size that you were talking about. So their top guy, this, and I'm probably butchering his last name, but Andrew, he's 6'6", 280. Their second ranked guy, 6'6", 220. Third ranked guy, 6'3", 215. Fourth ranked guy, 6'6", 235. They got a 6'3", 240 at fifth. Numbers at sixth ranked in the state, 6'7", 260. Seventh ranked in the state, 6'4", 260. I mean, so they got a lot of size.
See that, man.
They even got a guy that's ranked 9'6", 4", 315. So,
and that's what I'm. That's
a
what
lot
I'm
of saying. Size in Kansas. So if Nebraska wants to look at that,
that's what I'm saying. Though, we want to be getting Andrew Babalola.
Yeah,
6'6", 280, offensive tackle, the number one guy in Missouri. Matt Davidson, this is who we want. Matt's supposed to be bringing us some 1890 gear too. But
oh, is he?
Matty D, we want the big guys. We want big guys. If we're going to go to me, this is to me. If we're going to go to somebody else's state, let's go get the top five. Got one of the top five, right? Not number 13. That's just me. I'm not the coach, but I will say that.
But I do. I mean, it continues the trend of getting track speed to the football field. And so, you know, that's. I at least like that. I mean, they've obviously got a long ways to go. They have five guys committed. So, you know, it's going to be a bigger class than that, obviously. I don't know how big because they've got kind of a younger football team. But, yeah, it continues the trend to try to get that track speed out there. And I at least like that when you're talking about special teams, especially. You know, there's certain games where you play against an Ohio State or somebody and you just go, you know, a wide receiver runs by your safety and you're just going, oh, he's built different. You know, we're just not going to be able to keep up with him. At least if you've got some guys that have that type of speed, at least you can keep up with them.
Well, when you say track speed, he needs track speed, but he also needs football toughness.
And
football speed. Because if that guy is only thinking about running and burning somebody, once that safety hits him one good time and he feels it, then you got that guy who's going to be timid. So he got to be tough too now. I mean, because I'm a track guy, Bach, as we say too, though. But, you know, I played football all my life, and I ran track. So it's a different speed to run with all that stuff on and different gears you got to hit. But, you know, if football is football. Speed or not, you know, the game got to be played. And if a guy can run and take a hit and punishment, then that's the type of speed guy you want. But if you just got a guy who you just going to line up on the outside and never took a hit before, then that's probably not a guy you're going to want on your team.
Unless he's got 4.2 speed.
Yeah.
When he get to college, he ain't going to – that speed you talking about that you showing down in Kansas ain't going to be speed at Nebraska. It's just not. Now, we'll see. Overall, we'll see how this pans out. I just think if we're going to go to Missouri, if we're going to go out of the state, let's get these guys – let's really get somebody that's going to make them hurt. Not – the 13th. He's not even in the top 11. That's just me.
Yeah, so he ran a 10.69 100-meter dash.
Amon Green ran a 10.4.
Yeah, to compare that, Jalen Lloyd ran a 10.47.
Mm-hmm.
What did
Malachi Coleman run? What was his fastest he ran?
I'd have to look that up. I just had this. This was an article.
Don't know. I don't know about Bryson Hayes.
Well, you know, coach sees something in him that they like. So, you know, yeah, well, I mean, maybe.
We don't, and he could be, I think he's being recruited as an athlete.
I think he's being recruited as a receiver, but.
Is he really?
Yeah.
5'11". I mean, 5'11", good size, about Rashawn's size.
He might have stickums on his hand.
Yeah, got 5'11", you 5'11", so.
So what that make you, 5'8"?
Nah, 6'2".
Stop it. All right, Bach, let's go.
Some other news?
Yeah. We better get off of
well,
this.
Well, hey, I wanted to talk about this guy. I watched the USFL the other day, and it seems like they're turning into a kicker league. I mean, I seen a guy, this guy, Jason Bates, kicked a 64-yarder of Rashawn, and all four of his field goals has been long. So he had a 55-yarder yesterday, I watched. But for the season, he had 64, 62, and 52.
Oh, wow.
So
he'll get a shot.
Yeah, I mean, and then last year they had a guy, Aguilar, who signed with it, and I think he broke a record in the kicks. Well, he keeps for the Dallas Cowboys. But, you know, that's probably the only thing that excited me because I watched Adrian Martinez play yesterday.
How do you look?
He looked pretty good.
Quarterback?
Yeah, quarterback.
He started?
300-yard passing.
How many picks?
Took a safety in the end zone, so I said,
Did they win?
Yeah, they won like 35-16.
Okay, come on, Amar.
But he threw some good passes. He played okay. I mean, I like what I seen, but, you know, it's just that I don't watch that league like that.
You don't like the football quality.
Yeah, it's not top. I'm not going to say it's not top notch because it's not. But at the same time, it's still fun to watch because it gives us something to watch. But I'm more of a college NFL type fan. I just – football year-round ain't my thing.
Yeah.
I'm just – it's just not.
You came from Georgia, too.
Well, we don't do football year-round.
Ray, you got to get me in a text login. We'll get this because I got to get some text. Go to the text line right now.
And
quick.
Jake Bates is the name of the kicker, by the way.
Yeah, Jake
played
Bates.
At Arkansas for a bit.
Let's go to the text line. Read 1,000. What is 1,000 talking about?
It says first quarterback in USFL, which is UFL now, to throw over 300 yards.
Boom.
Which is that? Boom. That was the exciting part about Adrian.
Well, it's the first year this season, though. It's the first year this
team.
So why would you
make they played a few games?
Like they played 8 years. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Come on,
well, it's gonna be more
milestone, though. Get a guy his flowers while he can smell them, Terrell.
I watched the game. I did watch him.
You did. You said he looked good.
Yeah, I didn't say anything bad about the guy, but don't sit here and act like that's a 12-year-old record.
But it is, I mean, the problem with the XFL and the USFL the last couple of years has been quarterback play. You talk about lacking getting people's attention in a draw. Sometimes it's because the quarterbacks are struggling to score or throw for over 160 yards. So, I mean, if Adrian can consistently do that, I mean, I don't know about the NFL.
But
he could
be
the star of the UFL.
Yeah, they make a good money. Those quarterbacks are making money. He's good. Sit there. He could develop. He could do like Warren Moon did, go to Canada. Develop your game, then come back.
Scapper says, I know I'm slow, but that doesn't seem like much of a difference in the 100 meter. He's talking about the 0.2 seconds.
Are you kidding me right now?
About there.
Are you kidding me? So you're saying there's a 10-4 from a 10-6 is no different. Man, listen, a 10-4 and a 10-6 is a whole step. I'm coming a step in front of you. Shoom, shoom. That's how fast
it happens.
If you're
in a race, it's quite a bit of difference.
Oh, yeah. 10-4 versus a 10-6? Man, 10-4 is flying.
But 5-6-3-7 Texan, Hayes ran a 4-3-4 at Nebraska's camp last summer, which I know he ran a good time. I didn't know what it was, but I knew he ran a good time. That kind of caught their attention.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And T-Marker says Booth is a running back. They got him listed as athlete. Maybe Nebraska's already zeroed in him as a running back.
Yeah. That's saying something then. So now you figure out, okay, if he ran a 4.34, he's legitly fast. Mm. And you can't coach speed. You either got it or you don't.
Yeah.
So if he ran a 4.34 at camp, and he's got that legit speed, I think he's somebody that can come in and help us. I mean, we got to get guys that can either develop into guys or guys that can come in day one guys and help. Go back, text on. I'm liking the text.
I think that was all our text.
That's okay. Before. No. There's a lot of text on.
I think this is the previous show, but.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, then no, we don't want to answer any of those. Terrell, you good?
Yeah.
You good with that topic? Okay, Bach, react.
Well, another thing, too, and I mentioned this was I don't know if you guys saw this, but Ohio State had their spring game nationally televised on Fox. So that was interesting enough. And so a lot of the spring games were happening. Alabama's. Went well. Kalen DeBoer had a lot bigger crowd there than he did last year at Washington. But I told you guys about the Grove Bowl games, right? At Ole Miss, are they going to have all these different type of games? So I wanted to give an update on that. So the Red and Navy teams faced off. That in this was kind of like the Pro Bowl games, not necessarily spring game format. They had a dunk contest, 7-on-7 tug of war, hot dog eating contest, and a Grove Bowl gauntlet, which I don't know what that means, but necessarily. But anyways, the Red came out with a narrow victory, 71-70. Joey Chestnut did show up, and he helped the Navy team. He was on the Navy team, so he kind of helped that close, keep that thing close with the hot dog eating contest portion. He ate 20 hot dogs in 90 seconds.
Dang. He must be a big old boy.
Gross. And he's not that big.
90 hot dogs. Yeah. How many?
20 hot dogs in 90 seconds.
Would you dip your hot dog in water and then just stick
no.
it?
No.
Yeah, they...
I'm out. I don't eating contest. Me and eating contest don't work.
Not gonna do it.
Especially now. Yeah, okay. Can't eat that much.
Chicken wings.
No.
Mm-mm. Just the fats.
No. Mm-mm. I'm not gonna do all that eating stuff. I'll leave that to you. Yeah. You wanna throw it to break?
You think just because you're slim, you just think you're the man.
I can beat you running too.
No, you can't.
For the record, I blew my daughter's doors off. She last time we raced, I was 250. She beat me. This time though, the captain showed up. Yeah. So whenever you want to, again, nothing between me and you but space and opportunity.
Cash.
Whatever.
I don't run for free.
Throw it to break.
I don't run for free.
You do a whole bunch for something. Free. You Whatever. Do a bunch for free.
Whatever.
All right. The fastest 2 hours in radio has begun, and it is the Captain Show, and we are powered by Bauer. 1040 O Street. There they go.
93.7. The Ticket.
Several irrigation contractors in Lincoln go out of business every year, leaving sprinkler system orphans begging for service. The folks at Judson Irrigation shed a tear for these little fellas. They've been coddling these orphans for more than 40 years. From redesign, repairing, replacing, and restoring, remember the Judson Irrigation Orphanage.
Call the Judson Irrigation Orphanage, 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
In every office, there's two types of people. There are those who bring in bagels and those who eat the bagels that someone else brought in. Everybody likes the first person. Be that first person. Weekday mornings at 7:30, you have a chance to win a business box of bagels from Bagels and Joe. All you have to do is shut up Sipple. Two questions for you, two for Sip. Win and the bagels are yours. Lose, well, you don't want to lose.
You lost Monday, you lost Wednesday, you're a loser.
Shut up Sipple. Weekday mornings at 7:30, brought to you by Bagels and Joe.
Hi, I'm Senator Bo Ballard. I was born and raised in Lancaster County, learning the value of hard work and grit at a young age. I built my own company, creating jobs right here in our community. I know that families and businesses in our community need lower taxes, lower cost of health care, and a great education. That's why as your senator, I helped pass the largest tax cut and made the most significant investment in education in Nebraska history and worked to reduce the cost of health care. I'm Senator Bo Ballard, and I humbly ask for your vote on May 14th. Paid for by Ballard for Nebraska.
Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits is now open in Lincoln. Shop our expansive collection of wine, beer, spirits, and cigars at 5040 North 27th Street. From top-shelf liquor to crowd-favorite beer, Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits has a beverage for every taste and every budget. Plus, join our loyalty program to earn rewards and save on future purchases. Shop Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits at 5040 North 27th Street in Lincoln. That's 5040 North 27th Street.
Lincoln. You wanted more sweet and spice in your life, and now you've got it. At Wings and Rings, their brand new hot honey has all of Lincoln buzzing. Try their one-of-a-kind house-made sauce on the brand new hot honey chicken sandwich or their hot honey shrimp and slaw. And of course, you can get it on the traditional, boneless, or smoked wings that have made Wings and Rings your go-to neighborhood spot. Hot honey was supposed to be gone on April 1st, but they're extending it indefinitely. So stop by Wings and Rings at one of their two Lincoln locations today. On O Street and on Village Lane.
Have you been accused of a crime? Is your liberty and freedom at stake? At Liberty Law Group, we are committed to defending the liberty and pursuing justice for those accused. Going to court is stressful, overwhelming, and full of uncertainty. At Liberty Law Group, we carry that burden for you. When legal troubles are keeping you up at night, trust Liberty Law Group to fight your battles. Call 877-42-LIBERTY. That's 877-42-LIBERTY.
Take your internet service to new levels with Allo, your award-winning internet provider across our fiber hoods. Allo isn't just about the fastest internet available. It's about connecting you to your world, work, and play seamlessly. Our award-winning service ensures affordable, secure, and reliable connectivity, setting us apart. Ready to transform your internet experience? Experience the fiber difference today. Sign up now at allofiber.com. Allo. Connecting your world.
The need in our community, if you just look at the numbers, it's frightening. We're serving over 1,000 kids every day. With the passion of our people, I really feel like our potential to be of even greater service to kids and families who are struggling is just unlimited. But in order to have the greatest impact, we need all the help we can get from the community.
Your home is your empire. Protect it with Empire Fence. Get a free instant quote with the online estimating tool at empire-fence.com. See an upfront estimate with no hidden fees. An Empire Fence can provide privacy and improve the appearance of your home. Keep kids and pets in or out of your yard. Increase security and add value to your property. Visit empire-fence.com now to view the stylish and maintenance-free possibilities for your home and get a free instant online quote. Let Empire Fence protect your empire.
The dangers of secondhand smoke are well known, but what about secondhand aerosol, which is created when using e-cigarettes? Science already shows a secondhand aerosol can contain nicotine, heavy metals, and cancer-causing agents. Eliminating exposure to secondhand aerosol is an important step to keeping everyone safe. Breathe easier knowing the facts.
For help quitting, call the Nebraska Tobacco Quit Line. 1-800-QUIT-NOW. 1-800-784-8669. Paid for by Tobacco Free Nebraska. Aired with the Nebraska Broadcasters Association and this station.
Hi, Sean Callahan here of HuskerOnline.com, inviting you to join us here on 93.7 The Ticket every Saturday morning now in our new time. We're on from 8 to 9 with the weekly Husker Online radio show. We'll give you the latest in recruiting. We'll talk about what's going on with both football, basketball, and we'll probably share a few stories from the inside. It's every Saturday morning right here on 93.7 The Ticket. It's the Husker Online radio show from 8 to 9 a.m.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Can't be me, black shirt, can't beat me. Yeah. You can't beat me, black shirt, you can't beat me. You
look, man,
can't
don't get your feelings
beat
hurt.
Me, black shirt, you can't beat
you
me.
You want to go down to the track? Right? They still got the track by the university right
me,
there.
Black shirt, huh? You can't beat me.
You lucky I gotta do after. You lucky I gotta do after. I'm yada 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 yada
wow. the Crocs, I tell you that.
I will beat you in these Crocs.
Whatever.
Don't tell me.
Whatever.
He just
did. It ran about them.
Yo, don't they say you got speed mode? Whatever. You put them in. What you say? What was it called? Run mode? What's the mode they put them in?
I don't know. I'm not a Croc.
Hey, calm Connoisseur. Down. Why are you looking at my shoes like that, Bob? don't be looking at my shoes like
that. I don't think you can run in those either.
My grandkids.
I don't care what kind of mode you put those in.
Yeah.
I can run. This is in speed mode. Look, I'm running right now. Woo, 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 woo. Oh, don't tell me I can't run. Oh, don't tell me. I know I can beat you, Bob. All right? That ain't even the story.
No, I want you.
We're talking you two.
Yeah. Stay right here. Don't go over there.
I'm sorry.
Stay right here.
You said don't pick
stay
on your
in
buddy.
That lane you in right there.
Don't pick God. On your buddy.
Nah, you just
pick sport your, mode.
Yeah, whatever.
Thank you, 3477.
You would never beat.
I put him in sport mode.
You would never beat me in no Crocs. I tell you that. Kidding me. Whatever.
You is not the man you used to be,
Terrell. You are not the
You're
guy
not
you used to be.
Fleet footed as Yeah, I know. I've kind of trimmed
you
up a little bit.
You lost a little weight. Don't
that's
get
true.
You.
That's what that's for.
I'm going to make you feel like
just
you should have kept the weight on. And your
no,
little,
sir.
And your little, and
no, sir.
Tell your little cheerleader, Big Slim, to
no,
come
sir.
To watch this.
No, yeah. sir. No, yeah. sir.
Tell him to come have, we love VJ sign. Go, VJ.
Don't get mad because Big Slim said, I've seen both of y'all run in person.
So what?
Captain,
you
when
he seen you run.
Black shirt
he seen you
blows
ran the 400.
Tires too quickly.
He seen you run the 400.
Man, I'm fast.
Man, whatever, dude.
I know I'm fast.
Okay.
You.
Okay.
You know.
I'm
don't make me go there. Don't make me go there.
How much are you willing to bet?
Feel the thrill.
Appreciate nothing it. For free. How much are you willing to put down?
You call it.
$250.
No problem.
No problem. Let's shake on it. Let's shake on it.
Do you need to work out?
I don't need no time.
Now
you need to work out?
Race.
I don't
now
need
I'm
no.
Oh, now you're
I don't, now I'm
I don't
who
need,
you taking?
Hey, Bob, I don't need a week.
Who you taking?
I don't need a, week. I don't need, a day. I don't need 2 hours.
Who you taking?
We can go. We can,
I don't know if Trump did have that flat tire, though.
That was that tire.
I'm a little worried about
this
that.
Guy is not fast at all.
Yeah.
You know?
Otherwise, like, yeah. Injuries aside, I think I'm leaning toward Terrell.
Yeah.
I could beat him with a blown out tie.
Hey, listen, man. Raleigh W says four-wheel drive. Yeah, I'm going to put that thing all-wheel drive. You ever see one of them all-wheel drive Subarus?
You're one of those guys.
Little BRXs, WRXs?
Hey, look. He's one of those guys I would never have to worry about. That is no challenge.
Come on, dog.
None.
Come on.
Care if he was 200 pounds, Bob. Come on, he still won't.
Look, listen. We saw what you capable of.
Whatever.
You're not capable of producing the horsepower that you used to.
See, here's the thing.
You're going to blow out gaskets.
Hey, see, go down.
Cold days in the building.
See, here's the thing. Once I race against you, I'm in front of you. I won't push it no more. I just keep it in cruise control.
Yeah, don't do that.
So that's what
it's one just thing. Like when we did the deal out at Lincoln Sports Foundation.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah, you caught a one-yard pass. You caught a one-yard pass.
Put this on.
You caught a one-yard pass.
And he went that way, and I went this way.
A one-yard pass.
Wow. Yeah, but then you got to tackle me.
Yeah, that's no problem.
You wouldn't have made that.
Would
not have made that.
Whatever.
I would have shouldered you and lifted you right up out your drawers.
You'd have got caught.
Wow.
You'd have got a horse collar.
Down.
You'd have got a horse collar.
Why are you going to cheat?
Well, got to do anything I got to do to bring you down.
You cheat. How? Here, let me show you. Let me demonstrate it. Goodbye.
1 yard.
Caught the ball. You closed well.
Second and nine. Second and nine.
You're saying that you would have
second and nine.
You didn't tackle me.
11 guys run to the ball, VJ.
And then we saw what you did when you did the high knees. Remember, he was going over the back with high knees.
Yeah.
And you didn't look too good. You was kind of flopping over yourself, crossing over and stuff. You wasn't flat footed. Then I saw me go, and it was pop, pop.
Whenever you want to get your feelings hurt, young man, you more than welcome. You more than welcome. Like I said, I don't need 2 weeks. I don't need 3 weeks. I don't need 2 hours. We can do it at 12:22 today. We can go do this.
It looks a little fast for the LSU gear on.
Sport mode.
Something
about that down south speed.
Eye of the Tiger.
Trey Palmer.
Yeah.
That's they speed, not your
Trey
speed.
Trey Palmer.
That's Louisiana speed. You was born in Omaha.
Trey Palmer. Yeah. What you do? You trying to act like we don't have speed in Omaha?
Not you.
You got to be kidding me.
Not worried about you.
I would run past you quick.
Never.
I run past you on.
I bait tight ends.
You can't keep up with me, dude.
Whatever.
You ain't in shape no more.
Whatever. You're not
you're
in
just
shape.
Just running around and
you lost weight. I mean, it's a difference when you lose weight by working out. You lost weight by starving yourself.
That's not true.
You didn't lose weight by working out.
You ain't even went
around a block and jogged or nothing.
Watch this. You just watched it eat. You done?
Yeah.
Watch this. You can't do 50 push-ups.
Who cares? That's what I thought.
Well, what he said was, you lost weight by just starving yourself. That's what he said.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he said.
That's what you did.
Well, then there'd be no way that I can do 50 push-ups, right?
Yeah.
Huh?
Who cares about push-ups?
You said I wasn't working out, man.
Yeah.
Come on.
I get 20,000 steps a night.
I don't know. That means nothing.
Yeah, that's
walking.
That's
normal.
It's still.
You got to do extra.
Still.
You got to run extra. Horsepower.
I have to run.
And you can't do, I don't know if you could do 25 push-ups.
Whatever.
You let Steve the Dream Taylor come in here and out push-up you.
Whatever.
And he's 10 years older than you.
Yeah.
No excuse.
When was that, a year ago?
That wasn't a year ago, was it, Bob? That was the one since we moved here, right?
I think my fist is still messed up, so I have to squeeze my arm.
Your fist?
To do it. I have a weak grip.
Oh, no. Dude.
Okay? Football injury.
From what? When?
Long time ago.
Where?
It's here.
You never got hurt in Nebraska.
Yeah, but I used to get my hand taped up like a boxer.
So it's in 25 years later, it still hurt?
Yeah, it still hurt.
Oh, my God. We'll be right back.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
If you're a homeowner or a business owner, you have a lot of projects, and no one has an unlimited budget or time. Sunbelt Rentals makes all jobs less stressful, with no need to purchase large equipment or hire a crew. You can do it yourself with rentals and everything from aerators and power rakes for spring yard work, to stump grinders, concrete mixers, tile saws, and more. Check out their inventory in Lincoln, north of Cornhusker Highway on 56th Street, or online at sunbeltrentals.com.
At Southeast Community College, community is our middle name. Our continuing education classes offer personal interest, traffic safety and licensing, online learning, and adult education classes across Southeast Nebraska, or online in your own home. Learn to ride a motorcycle, how to start a small business, how to dance, or take a course to advance in your current career path. See the full schedule of continuing education classes online at southeast.edu/continuing. SCC, your path to possible.
Have you been accused of a crime? Is your liberty and freedom at stake? At Liberty Law Group, we are committed to defending the liberty and pursuing justice for those accused. Going to court is stressful, overwhelming, and full of uncertainty. At Liberty Law Group, we carry that burden for you. When legal troubles are keeping you up at night, trust Liberty Law Group to fight your battles. Call 877-42-LIBERTY. That's 877-42-LIBERTY.
Hi everyone, Kendall Warnock, A1 Automotive in downtown Lincoln. Spring is here, summer is fast approaching. With weddings, vacations, and weekend getaways on your mind, do not let car issues prevent you from getting where you need to be. Car problems shouldn't be something that you put up with. Let us get you back on the road in comfort and safety. We diagnose all makes and models from Porsches to Hondas, Toyotas, and Chevrolets. We fix a variety of issues with all of them with our talented techs and our experienced staff. A1 Automotive at 11th and L, downtown Lincoln. Always honest answers.
If you're in Seward or Milford, listen up. Select Plumbing is now servicing your area with no trip charges from Lincoln. Select Plumbing works on a variety of issues for your home and business, including general plumbing, water heaters, faucet and fixture repair, underground sewer and water repairs, backflow testing, and more. Keep your property free from leaks and other issues. Call today for a free estimate, 402-560-6197. It's not just Lincoln, Waverly, and the surrounding area anymore. It's also Seward and Milford with no trip charges. Contact Select Plumbing to inquire at 402-560-6197.
Are you looking to get into the electrical construction industry or wanting a new scene? The Electrical Workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
Not many businesses can say they've made it 60 years, but Madsen's Bowling and Billiards can. With 12 bowling lanes and the biggest pool room in Nebraska, where else would you go to enjoy an afternoon or evening? There's a great daily specials like $2 Tuesdays, games of bowling, shoe rentals, draft beers, and tacos, all just $2 each. Have a delicious burger at EJ's Lounge before or after your bowling or pool session, and you'll leave satisfied. Madsen's Bowling and Billiards at 47th and Dudley.
In every office, there's two types of people. There are those who bring in bagels and those who eat the bagels that someone else brought in. Everybody likes the first person. Be that first person. Weekday mornings at 7:30, you have a chance to win a business box of bagels from Bagels and Joe. All you have to do is shut up Sipple. Two questions for you, two for Sip. Win and the bagels are yours. Lose, well, you don't want to lose.
You lost Monday, you lost Wednesday, you're a loser.
Shut up Sipple. Weekday mornings at 7:30, brought to you by Bagels and Joe.
On the Block with Strick and Austin.
When you're in New York, Nick, in New York, I mean, you're talking about, you see mafioso types. You go into a restaurant and you would literally eat. Hey, come over here. You know, they, you know, I don't know how to say it. I don't got the accent, but they would say, come over. Have a drink on me. And what are you going to do? Say no?
You don't say no to the drink.
Say no.
Weekdays from 2 to 4 on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com. Early break with Sip and Jake.
I called. You didn't return the call. A couple times yesterday. No, nothing.
But I did. Crickets. Hold it. I called crickets. First, and then I got this. I don't know where Sip was. If you're in the bathroom, I get the. He goes,
hey, hang tight. I'm writing right now.
And I don't know. I'm like, well, why are you whispering to me? You said it just like that.
Hey, sit tight on that one. I'm writing right now.
And I'm like, what is he doing? Is he in the bathroom or what? Where are you at?
Can you give us the scoop on what happened?
Yeah,
there,
where were you when I called you? Because I did call you back.
Hang tight. I'm right.
Early break with Sip and Jake from 6 to 8 every weekday morning on 93.7 The Ticket. This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown! Vershawn Jackson, number 34,
gets the touchdown.
Terrell Farley. Defending Terrell Farley,
who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakoven.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
I can't, that's all I can do. Yeah, well, I had to fire Terrell, guys. For his next segment, because he wasn't acting right. So, you know, we get off the air, and I don't know why. It's supposed to be a black shirt thing, Bak. Like, these guys think they're so tough. Dude, you're not tough anymore. That black shirt mystique ran out the door 25 years ago. Okay? Now, that being said, I had to go ahead and smack him up and then fire him. Tell him to go home. Take a shower, come back and try it again before the show's over. So I sent him home. He's going to go get him a shower, dust off, come back when he's a little bit calmer and acting like he's got some sense. Okay?
I don't think he's going to have any less fire than when he gets
back. Oh, no. He's going to come back. He's going to be just docile.
Mellow, yeah.
He won't be hostile.
I don't know.
And he's definitely not agile or mobile. Mm. Well, I'm just saying. And if you wait a while, you will see VJ smash him. Let's do it for the spring game. That's next week. Spring game, 2 weeks.
Yeah, 2 weeks.
You looking forward to the spring game?
I'm looking for the spring game. It just dawned on me that it will, like, Nebraska's only chances of, well, I shouldn't say only chances, but likely only chances to get anybody drafted will be on the same day as the spring game. That'll be kind of interesting because that'll be the fourth through the seventh round of the draft will be that night.
Who's got a chance to get drafted? Stop it. There's who?
Newsom?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't.
I think he's got a chance to make a team. He's going to be one of those guys like Boodle, right? Mm-hmm. That'll go free agent. Yeah. But he's good enough that he should have got drafted. But because of whatever, he didn't. But he's still stuck with a team. So I think he's good enough to stick with a team. I don't know if a team is going to say, we're going to not waste. We're going to spend a draft pick on you, not necessarily knowing who's going to show up. And a lot of times, they can tell you whatever they want to. The NFL is looking at how many times you have been injured in your college career. Okay, I found my NFL notes. Okay, so, you know, everything that they've got. I've got every test that they ran on me, how big my hands were. So I got to bring in. Yeah, I got it all, right? And then they start classifying you as a guy who is a, you know, you're a day two guy, fifth to seventh round to free agent. So it's really interesting to see that. I just don't know if we got a guy that's draftable. Who?
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you. I think it's going to be, I mean, if you do get somebody, it's probably going to be seventh round. Omar Brown is another one people consider, maybe Luke Reimer, but Marcus Washington.
You can't. Listen, how many guys got all Big Ten? First round. First, whatever, all Big Ten. Terrell Williams wants to see you. Just hurry up and get your wash. There you go.
There you go.
Okay, so how many, you got the answer to that or no?
I can look back into it. I don't think, I mean, none of these guys.
Well, see, that when you know we arrive is when we're like Michigan. Oh, 28 players off of Michigan's team is going to have an opportunity to get drafted.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So you got to recruit that you know potential. You know what a guy's that got the potential to do X. Now you got to put him in a position and an environment to get him where you want him. And I think that we just got to recruit. I don't think we should be recruiting from a position of weakness. I don't know if you guys understand what I mean by that. Meaning, if the top five kids in every state are not being recruited by us, then we are recruiting from a position of weakness. Because I'm quite sure you get a good shower and everything. Good job. You okay? You calm down? You calm down? You good? I'm just, You good, right? I was just making sure you good. You good? You good?
What's wrong?
I was just making sure you was good. You good?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Figured you'd come down, come back a little cool.
Well, no.
Yeah, that's okay.
I'm still upset, though. But you trying, man.
We're not gonna air our differences out on air, Terrell. We're not doing it.
So Luke Remmer, by the way, was a third team All Big Ten, according to coaches. And I think he was the only Nebraska representative.
Yeah, and he didn't even leave the team in tackles.
Yeah, that seemed to be more of like a preseason name
that was
taking
a good,
over.
We're gonna throw, yeah, because they preseason All-American him. That's right. And so how bad of a call would that be to say, okay, he's a preseason All-American?
But I mean, for what it's worth, it's the coaches, it's not the media. So somebody was impressed with him.
I thought Reimer is a great football player. He seemed to fall off last year. Wasn't the same Reimer. Look at his tackle production.
Oh, yeah.
You can't tell me that you can be third on the team in tackles and you're the guy that gets the third spot or what, the third team coaches. How?
New defense.
No, hold up, dog. I just said, how would you feel if you had 80 tackles, right? Me and Bach had this many, and then I got honorable mention or third team All Big Ten with 30 less tackles than you. Explain how do you take that?
Well, it's the coaches. So the coaches did vote on it. So it's you know, Luke Reimer been around for years. So
just because the coaches voted on it, that make it right?
I mean, some coaches felt like that he was the heart and soul of Nebraska defense. So you got to figure in. I mean,
he did have 5 sacks.
Yeah, I mean, you got to understand.
No,
he's pretty good for linemen.
I'm not saying like that, but when you say coaches, the coaches do vote on it.
I know.
So the coaches like something that they seen out of Reimer enough to vote him 13.
I get it, but I just think that would you vote him 13? Would you vote him in front of the other two guys on defense that out tackled him? Javon Wright and we talked about him Friday.
Gifford.
Two totally different positions. One of them, Gifford is.
You keep on trying to get into the nuances. I'm talking about as a defense, sir.
I mean, if the coaches voted him, I mean, you can't hate on the situation that they voted him.
A question, sir. The question was, if all three of us played together, you had 80 tackles. He had 450, and I have 40, yet I'm the third team guy that the coaches voted on. You telling me that makes it right? Because we played different positions?
I don't know, VJ. It's hard to analyze that with the coaches that's been in the league for probably – that played against Reimer for 4 years.
Well, so is he getting – is he getting these accolades for what he did for over four years, or is he getting them for what he did over the year?
Probably over the years.
Okay. Well, I mean, I get it. I'm just simply saying, and I think Reimer's a great player. I think injuries, you know, he got hurt last year, so I think injuries played a part in him kind of not playing up to his potential. But as far as playing on the next level, if Reimer continues with the motor that he has, somebody's going to give Reimer an opportunity, and I can see Reimer, because of his motor, because of his special teams play, being around the league for the next 6-7 years. Like, what's my guy that went to the Colts?
JoJo
Doman. Yeah. Same thing.
Yeah, I mean, and it's. I think you're at least saying he wasn't his old self. Remember in 2021, he had 108 tackles.
Think about that.
As opposed to 48 last year. So,
see?
Well, yeah, and plus you got to say it's that 3-3-5. Like I say, you got 5-on-3 on the line. So, you know, unless these guys don't demand, you know, the double teams, then, you know, they don't have guys that demand double teams. So it's easier to reach him.
For what it's worth, too, he did miss 2 games.
Yeah.
Tackles we played.
For me, playing on the defense with Christian, Jason, Jared, and Grant, you have to chip block one of them. And that way you're using all 5 blockers. So, of course, your linebacker is going to be free. Now, this year, it may be a little different because I think probably those two guys, them two big guys, probably going to deserve a double team or a chip shot. Mm-hmm. So, you got to understand that. And that's going to make it more easier for these linebackers. Everything based off linebackers is based off how good your defensive line is. That what makes you a great linebacker, because them guys let you roam free. Those guys take most of the hits from the offensive lineman. And plus it's a new defense. So, you know, you got to get a kid some kind of credit.
Are you sure you're a black shirt?
Yeah, I mean, I am, but
just making sure. Doesn't seem like
it. I'm the black shirt. Yeah. The black shirt. Yeah.
What you want? Well, why don't you speak like it? Why don't you act like it?
Well, I'm not going to take anything away from a black shirt brother just because he had a bad year. I mean,
I'm not saying that. I'm not going bad on Reimer. I love Reimer.
I mean,
I'm
I played probably six games my senior year, and I made third team, so I can't take it away from him. What am I going to say about that then?
My point. Okay. My point exactly.
Okay.
My but point
I did
exactly.
Enough, but I did enough, but then look I did at your enough stats, in six though. Games to... To make it like that, and he probably played 8-9 games. So
he played 10, yeah.
He played 10 games.
Stat-wise, what did you do in those six games?
Probably a couple of sacks, couple of
blocks. Would you like third or fourth on the team in tackles?
Yeah.
Okay. See? All right. I get that. But then we had other guys that were first team.
Yeah.
All defense. First team. Second team. All defense. Okay. So you can say you can, when we look at the grand scheme of things, we forget it. Go ahead.
You know, there's another guy that is kind of interesting, Anthony Grant. I know you thought. Do you still think he could make it in the league?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think he's got
not draftable, probably, but
he should have been draftable. He should slide into somebody's seventh round. Mm-hmm. You know, you slide into him like you know you'd be talking about sliding into people's DMs. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You got to slide. You can slide him into your team like you slide in a DM because I'm telling you now, he will help a football team. That's just what I think.
Yeah, I see him as probably a free agent. I think the fumbles really hurt him last year. Coming out as a starter and almost 1,000 yards his junior year to come back and have, what, 200-300 yards? That's,
if he had 413.
Yeah, 413. Yeah. But at the same time, it you know, the NFL looks at stuff like that. And, you know, when the coaches talk to him, you don't know how the coach is going to say, well, he'll be a great running back. So, you know, you look for a guy like that to start off on probably practice roster, work his way up, and hopefully some injuries, you know, get him in the game, and he shows out then. But yeah. Getting drafted wild, I just probably think it's a free agent for him after the year he had last year.
I mean, I agree, but I think he might be able to backdoor his way in the seventh round.
Yeah.
So somebody's going to give him an opportunity because I'm telling you, they're going to go back and watch the tape from a year ago and say, what happened to this? Maybe this guy still got that. You know what I mean? Especially when you start getting paid to play, your focus is a lot different, right? And I think, you know, somebody taking – young Grant under their wings, I think they're gonna get a steal of a value getting him at seventh round or a free agent, and he's going to play 4 or 5 years. I really think he's got the potential to do that. Billy Kemp, he'll get into somebody's club. I think he'll help if as long as he can help in the punt return game. I think the biggest Washington.
Marcus Washington.
Yes. I think the sleeper is Marcus Washington. Depending on how, and I don't know how he tested out. Anybody know that?
I don't know. Obviously, nobody went to the combine, but for the pro days, I'm not sure. Also interested to see where Nori goes, Nori Nwuele.
He'll get a shot.
Yeah, he's definitely going to get a shot, so it'll be exciting. Nebraska, unfortunately,
where has, is he from? He's not from Canada, is he?
No.
No.
Oh, okay.
From over
from Germany, I think.
Germany.
But speaking of the Dutch. Nebraska has a little bit of a history of guys, offensive linemen going undrafted, not maybe fully what you'd say reaching your potential or whatever, because then they play in the NFL for a while.
Well, a bunch of them.
Yeah. Man,
there's a ton of examples of guys, Nebraska guys not going drafted, going free agent, and then sticking on a club for 5-10 years and having a good career and getting the heck out of there. And so I just think that there's a couple of potentials there for some of these guys to get in where they fit in and maybe just backdoor their way into a nice NFL football career. And we all be like, well, what happened at Nebraska? Why wasn't he that good at Nebraska? You know what I'm saying? So I just think you sit back and hopefully these guys are putting their best foot forward and they're giving everything they got in some. You all right, Terrell?
Yeah.
He's just looking. Go ahead. He ain't responding.
I'm trying to look for his pro day.
He ain't responding.
The pro day numbers?
Yeah.
He ain't responding.
I did want to mention this and ask you about it because it was it's a former teammate of yours. Chris Norris is at Arkansas now. Arkansas is hiring Chris Norris as a special teams analyst. Norris was a former Nebraska fullback, part of the 94 and 95 team. I believe he played 94, was a student assistant in 95 due to injuries, and he was at Western Carolina the last couple of years as special teams coach. So loosen up in the coaching ranks.
I think he went with Coach Samuel too when Coach Sam went, I think New Mexico or one of those stops that Coach Mexico Sam State. Had. Yeah, he's been coaching for a long time now. But Chris Norris is a friend of mine. I consider him a bigger brother to me because he was in that fullback room. And me and Norris got acquainted real quick because we were on scout team together. You know, and Chris Norris was a walk-on who worked his butt off. And I just think that I know he had an injury. I think he broke his neck or something like that. But Chris Norris is one of those unsung guys who come in, they walk on, and they don't complain. They give you everything they got and then some. So shout out to him for getting that opportunity. I hope that one day Chris Norris can come back here.
Yeah, yeah. That's he seems to be well on his way, hopefully. Another one, this is not a former Husker, but just a notable another move in the coaching ranks. Hines Ward, of course, the former Steelers tight end, one-time Georgia quarterback, Steelers wide receiver, Super Bowl MVP even. He's agreed to become Arizona State's next wide receiver coach.
Nice.
So he was a former wide receiver coach at FAU, was kind of he's coached around in the XFL with the Jets there for a second, but yeah, so a couple of coaching moves to look out for.
All right, shout out Hines Ward for getting that. I think Hines, who better not to be a coach than a receiver who actually did it and did it at a high level and did it when people said he couldn't because he was small.
Yeah, 6'2" and one of the best blocking wide receivers of all time.
One of the best wide receivers of all time. Probably the best blocking wide receiver of all time.
Yeah.
He would smack you. All right, what else you got? Nothing.
Nothing.
The text line. Good text line. Well, let me take the text. Let me make the text line take us out of here. Oh yeah. City Worker says, tough to compare the stats year to year. Completely different defense. Didn't scheme, and what was asked of him, they also rotated guys a lot more. That's true. That's true. Appreciate that, City Worker. Listen, 93.7 The Ticket's the Captain Show. We'll be right back.
If you're in Seward or Milford, listen up. Select Plumbing is now servicing your area with no trip charges from Lincoln. Select Plumbing works on a variety of issues for your home and business, including general plumbing, water heaters, faucet and fixture repair, underground sewer and water repairs, backflow testing, and more. Keep your property free from leaks and other issues. Call today for a free estimate, 402-560-6197. It's not just Lincoln, Waverly, and the surrounding area anymore. It's also Seward and Milford with no trip charges. Contact Select Plumbing to inquire at 402-560-6197.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you are passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
Take your internet service to new levels with Allo, your award-winning internet provider across our fiber hoods. Allo isn't just about the fastest internet available. It's about connecting you to your world, work, and play seamlessly. Our award-winning service ensures affordable, secure, and reliable connectivity, setting us apart. Ready to transform your internet experience? Experience the fiber difference today. Sign up now at allofiber.com. Allo, connecting your world.
Go Hog Wild Pit Barbecue.
If the week's been too hectic to even think about dinner, or your family can't handle one more night of leftovers, then it's time to let Hog Wild do the cooking. Hog Wild's family packs are one heck of a good deal for a complete barbecue meal loaded with all the smoked meats, tasty sides, buns, and sauces you need to feed your family. Order online at GoHogWild.com. Hog Wild Pit Barbecue, 3210 Cornhusker Highway in Lincoln.
But don't be late, we close at 8.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
One action, no matter how small, can have a world of impact on the life of a child. Cedar started because one couple believed that they could provide a child with a better life. And that belief grew into the Cedars that we know today, a powerful force for good that helps thousands of kids across Nebraska. belief grows.
Working at Continental in Lincoln isn't a job, it's a career. And right now, they've raised wages again, and they're hiring for production operators at $24.62 per hour, which grows to $28.97 per hour within 3 years. Skilled trade positions now start at $33.36 per hour, with opportunities to make more based on certifications. Continental also has salary jobs available and great benefits, plus medical and prescription costs at very low premiums. Dental, vision, and life insurance are offered at no premium cost to the associates, with increased bonuses and vacation for new hires. To learn more or apply, go to continentaljobs.com with keyword Lincoln. Come work at Continental today.
Biggest question people have is, how do I start the process? What is the process? I want to build a new home, but I don't know what the first step is.
Bob Benish is the founder and president of Aspen Builders, online at aspenbuildersinc.com.
The first step is make an appointment. Come on into my office. Let's sit around the table. Let's talk about what you're looking for, what your needs are, what your budget might be. And let's come up with some answers on what we're going to build, where we're going to build it, and what it's going to cost.
So now is really the time to be contacting us to get an appointment to get the job done before school starts.
Once you find a good lot, let's get it reserved, because there's a very limited number of lots in this town. And then start designing that floor plan that's going to be perfect for you. Next thing you know, we're moving dirt.
Make your dream home a reality and call Aspen Builders at 423-6811. Online at aspenbuildersinc.com. Your home is waiting at Aspen Builders.
The Double the Savings sales event is happening now through April 22nd at Bonsall Pool and Spa. During this event, buyers can take advantage of up to $1,500 in savings and receive 0% APR for 60 months. Visit the Bonsall Pool and Spa showroom at 33rd and Pioneers, or visit their website at bonsallpool.com to learn more about their hot tub sale. Act fast, because this offer ends soon. Bonsall Pool and Spa, every day made better.
At Union Bank, people don't have your money. Your money has people. First Home people, investment people, people people, people who answer the phone and your chats, dream car people, dream retirement people, driving your dream car in your dream retirement people, small business people, credit card people, and all the other people you need. At Union Bank, our people help you do more than you dreamed possible. So stop in and say hello. We can't wait to see you. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Hi, it's Charlie Stone back with the latest update from Andy Goodyear of Honda of Lincoln. Andy, your new car selection keeps getting better and better every month. Can you tell our listeners all about it?
You know, it sure is, Charlie. It's great that our customers can come in, pick out a new Honda, and drive away with it that day.
How many new Hondas do you have in stock?
Well, right now we have just about 100 in stock.
Hey, I hear you've won some very important awards in your service department. Tell us about them.
Well, the first one is we won the award for the first fixed award. So the cars are actually fixed on the very first time they're brought in. Second award is our customer service experience award. And then our third award is our Honda Express Service Elite. And we rank the best in quality and customer satisfaction.
Maybe it's time you come experience the Honda of Lincoln way of doing business, 27th and Yankee Hill Road, or online at hondaoflincoln.com.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
That's how we walking in, like Ric Flair. At the beginning of the game, that's how I walk in. First game, spring game, I'm walking like that.
All right.
Hey, could you put this chair back on that side of the room, sir?
Hey, why you gotta be so difficult?
Because there's no way this chair.
I don't sit down during the show.
Four chairs on my side.
I don't sit down during the show. That's the problem. I don't sit down. That's how I know I'm in better shape than you. You sit down every show. Every show, you get in your seat.
Ooh.
I'm just saying.
Because I've been working since probably 2 o'clock in the morning.
Don't nobody want to hear that.
Yeah, okay, thank
Sound
you.
Like a personal problem.
Yeah, whatever.
We all got jobs outside
okay.
of here.
Okay.
Except for Bob.
I have jobs outside.
Oh, Bob got jobs outside of here, too.
He's a daddy.
Yeah, so don't be getting mad at Big Slim for letting it be known what it is, bro.
Big Slim don't know nothing.
They do.
Yeah, he's just a VJ.
Shout out to Big Slim and the boys, Bauer, and all those big truck drivers. Amaya out there driving those trucks.
What is it? Infrastructure?
Bauer?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Underground.
Bauer? We should do it backwards.
Try it.
Yeah, but I can't do it. I gotta do it. Go.
Brand.
No, you can't. You gotta go backwards. So it's just
underground.
Bauer.
Infrastructure.
Bauer.
Excavated.
Brain.
Box. See, you see the brain that I have, Box? You see how fast I got that correct?
What's wrong with Box? What's his deal?
I don't know.
That's your best buddy. You should know.
He's shaved. He's clueless today.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
He looks all crispy.
Yeah, he looked like a science teacher.
That's what I thought. I look like John Stewart from the faculty.
A science teacher.
Yeah. Mr. Brassfield.
That Clark Kent.
That was my science teacher in high school, Mr. Brassfield.
Really?
Yeah, he's a baseball coach, so pretty easy.
What do you got, Bob? Come on, let's go.
I did want to get you guys' opinion on something that Jared Crick said with Adam Carricker on Friday. He's got one player that he pointed out that he thinks has first-round potential that might surprise you. And that's not for this upcoming year, but on Nebraska's team.
Roster.
So let's listen to it, and I want to get your guys' thoughts on it. There's also some other things in there that's kind of interesting. So here, it's about a minute long, but it's interesting here. This is, again, Jared Crick, former All-American at Nebraska with Adam Carricker last Friday.
Key to this defensive line playing up to what is a very high potential and expectations in the fall?
I think their depth's going to be key. I liked watching a kid, I forget his name, but James Williams maybe. You know, I think he might have kept his red shirt. I think he stayed under that 4-game limit, but just watching him get off the rock, I mean, that dude's a first round talent in my opinion. And the other guys may turn out to be as well, but he's kind of one of them kids that, you know, not a lot of people are talking about, I don't think. And that he caught my eye immediately. So just having those kind of guys where they can rotate in where, you know, I know Nash and Ty are kind of different builds from these other kids, but yeah, if you can just fill some guys in to come give them a blow, you know, I think that's one of the good things about a 3-3 where you're only, you know, throwing in three dudes at once opposed to four where, yeah, if you only got six guys who are game ready with a 4-man front, yeah, two of those guys are going to be hurting after a while because obviously you flip in two for the other two. But if you have six guys game ready with a 3-man front, obviously you can, you know, a whole new line change. It's almost like hockey.
So there you go. There's Jared Crick the other day on Adam Carricker on the Ticket. So in one way, kind of defending the line change there. I think that's kind of interesting to kind of think of it like hockey, have six guys on the defensive line ready. But how about James Williams?
Freshman that kind of showed flashes? What number?
Yeah, he's number 90.
That was a junior college guy, wasn't
he? Yeah, he came from Iowa Western Community College, and yeah, he was.
Is that the first Iowa Western guy we've gotten in 20 years? I didn't even know we got the kid.
Yeah. Yeah, well, nobody did. That was the thing. It's like, I can't remember what game it was, but there was some. He ended up getting 4 tackles, 2 sacks last year because he was impressing enough on the scout team. They're going like, we got to put this guy in. Now, they did save his 4 games, so they kept his red shirt on him. So I think he'll only be a sophomore this upcoming year. But, you know, and I was impressed with him too. But it's one thing for me to say it and think it, and it's another thing for a former All-American to think maybe first round potential from him.
Yeah, I think Jay Crick's on to something. I like the kid too. And I was wondering, to this day, I didn't even know who he was. Like, who the heck is this dude?
Well, when I think probably first round, I'm leaning more towards Cam Linhart. You know, if we can get him to have the year that he needs to have and play the amount of plays that we need him to play, because that kid has great talent. I mean, he started the season off real high. And for him to be 18, he can only get bigger and stronger and faster. So, if I want to think that far ahead, I want to think about Ken Linhart because of what he did last year and what they probably expect for him this year to go all out.
Who do we think would be the highest draft pick from this football team? So going into next year, who's got the potential to be the highest pick on this team?
Who? I don't know yet. That's I have to see this team play first because, you know, it could be a running back. It could be a receiver. It could be a linebacker. I mean,
based on what you've already saw, who would you say has got the
The potential. It's just potential.
Probably Cam Linhart.
Okay, so you're going to ride with Cam. What about you, Bob?
I would say Nash Huttmacher and Ty Robinson would be
in a fight. You can't say Cam Linhart. He ain't coming out next year.
Well, I know he's not coming out.
We're talking about the guys that are coming out.
Probably them two big guys in the middle. I think they, Ben Scott, you know, he's going to be up there. So
yeah, Ben Scott.
You probably got to think about Ben Scott first before anybody, because that center, if he's that good of a center, he might be a second or third rounder.
I'm going to go out on a limb. I think that the X factor we're missing out is Javon Wright. I think when you start, because you got to, NFL is going to look at measurables, right? 6'4", 215, 220, can run, can jump long. They're looking at that, and to me, that gives you the best potential. If he has a breakout year, I can see him going day one. I'm not saying first round, but I think, you know, I can see him going day one. Danico says MJ Sherman is another guy. What do you guys think about MJ Sherman?
Got it. Came in with a lot of hype. Didn't really play that role that I thought he would play last year. A whole bunch of them didn't. So, you know, it's the thing about learning that defense. Maybe him and Chief Borders, you know, they share the same position. So one of those guys got to come out on top. And plus you have the new guy from Syracuse also coming in, and he probably is going to get in shape and get his act together. So, you know, that's a position we'll have to watch probably in fall.
Jamari Butler, another name.
Shoot. You got to put him
definitely
in
there. Definitely have it.
Yeah.
In the conversation.
He's my next one, like Cam and him. Or the future guys that I think that can really.
I think Chief Borders too. I think he's got the potential to be not next year, but I'm saying down the line. You know, he's only a sophomore. He's got time. I think you got to look now. 3 years from 2 years from now, right? 2 years from now, we should be super excited, thinking to ourselves, "Holy smokes, look what we got!" That's just what I feel. 2 years from now. You know, you get Dylan, and you get the rest of our quarterbacks, and you get us in the right direction. Harburg and all those guys will be seniors. It'll be more of a senior-led team. And I think when you have, again, senior-led teams, it equals wins and championships.
Well, it's interesting, too, because, I mean, they're going to have a lot of seniors on this team. You think, you know, you look at obviously the quarterback position, so you think, well, Nebraska is kind of young, but their offensive line is going to have what, four probably senior starters potentially there. The defense might have eight senior starters. So, I mean, this is the year to kind of make that move in my mind, of course, with bringing along a freshman quarterback. But the thing is, it's almost no matter what you do this year, it's not like your quarterback play is going to get a whole lot worse. Maybe that's unfair because Heinrich Harburg did step in and get five wins and help lead Nebraska in that way. But obviously we know that wasn't a dynamic offense.
No, I mean, they struggled. And they struggled because we didn't have an identity. We didn't know what we were wanting to run. We didn't know if we wanted to be a run first, run heavy quarterback team or shotgun team or don't have the receivers for it. This is the first year in a long time where I look at this football team and I know what we are. Okay? We're a pro-style team with a drop-back quarterback. Hopefully we get a run game and we got receivers that can go get the ball. And other than that, you add protection to it. You put a defense that we thought was pretty good last year. You give them another year to develop. You got to find a corner. You have got to find a corner on the other side. And then I think if you can put it together and put our special teams together, we'll be all right. Here's my question. Who do we have as special teams at punt returner? Is there an electrifying punt returner?
I mean, Ethan Nation was kind of getting a few reps there at the end.
And I didn't pay attention to that when I went to practice, so I don't really know what's what. But I think you got to have a guy as far as in a punt return guy that's got, you know, it's got the heart of steel and is not afraid to catch the ball with guys 3 yards away from him, make one man miss, and maybe get missing. But we've been lacking that in the last 10 years. We haven't had a punt return guy worth his salt since DeMornay Personnel, I think.
Yeah, I mean, and a lot of the years, I mean, you're talking about the Scott Frost years, they would just fair catch the ball and not even an attempt to return it. So, I mean, and you've got special teams coaches. I mean, and they have had them. They have one now. You know, that needs to be high on his priority list, is if you're bringing in all this track speed that they like to talk about, you know, maybe one of those guys as a kick returner or a punt returner could trick it off. But I mean, it's it's obviously there's a difference between just flat line speed and the dynamics that make you a good returner. But Nebraska should have a few different. I mean, you think of maybe Garcia Castaneda, like I said, any of those guys, you know, Jalen Lloyd or one of those guys that are pretty quick. But obviously you have to be able to catch the ball and bring it in. That's been a problem for Nebraska in the past too, even if you did have the dynamic athletes.
Well, if you don't catch the ball, you don't win. You don't have guys that can go get the ball, that will make a play on the ball, that won't let the ball get interception. They'll become a defensive back. That's the guy you want, the guy that will attack the ball in the air. You know, and I think Isaiah Nair is that guy. I think Jalen Lloyd is that guy. I think Malachi Coleman could be the guy. You know, I think he's still nursing that shoulder injury. And you've got a couple other guys, those younger receivers. You know who I like? Who I think he ain't getting credit, but I think he will. What's the other receiver from Bellevue West? What's his name?
Okay, the guy's coming in.
Yeah, he's here already, though.
Yeah.
What's the receiver's name? I can't remember from Bellevue West.
Davon Hall?
Davon Hall. Yeah. Dude, Davon Hall's going to be a player, man. He looks, to me, he looks better now than he did in high school. And because I thought he was good in high school, but I just thought he was just a speed guy, right? And he looks better now to me. When I see him out there moving around, I'm like, I can see him in a year being a juice guy, like a real get the ball in his hand, and he's explosive after the catch.
I can't pronounce the name, but somebody on the chat says Ramir Johnson can be that guy.
Danico.
Maybe if he doesn't win, you know, the running back job or in the top couple spots there, maybe that's something he could focus on.
Well, as far as what? Punt return?
Yeah, punt return, kick return.
I don't think so. I think he's gotten too big to do punt return. I like him at kickoff return. I think both of those two guys, excuse me, should be the starting kickoff return guys. If they're not going to be starters, I think you let them go out there and start. They're going to be seniors. So they got to be a leader in that department and in that category too. So I think you give them an opportunity to start the game off by being the kick return guys. And I think that'll get the fans excited about what we got going on. We see what you sent. We see what you sent, Notorious B.I.B. Did you see what Notorious B.I.B. sent? He's got some pictures of some fish. Brother Jerry went fishing east of Lincoln. Look at those big things.
All right.
Ooh. Big old bubble eye. Bubble eye fish. Was that a trout?
No, that's a bubble catfish.
That ain't no catfish. You look like a catfish. Before
that's a bass.
Eh? I just said that. It got to be a big old bubble eye bass here. Oh, okay. Always looking no good. You see it? Is that a bass? It's a bubble eye bass. B.I.B. What kind of fish is that one with the big old eyes? Or did his eyes just swole up after y'all caught him? And he was like, "Oh my god!"
I need to go get my fishing license.
You do. So yeah. You go fishing with the Notorious B.I.B. and his brother Jerry. I wouldn't mind on my way out of town going.
It's yard sale.
Yard sale season.
Is it really?
Yeah.
We should go see if we can find some old school Husker memorabilia.
Oh yeah, that's popular.
I'm having a yard sale probably in a couple of weeks.
You don't have anything good that you sell.
Whatever.
What do you got?
Hey, there's Tommy Armstrong.
Is it?
Yep.
And he been, I ain't no
that's Tommy. That's not Tommy Armstrong.
This dude, this is a little wait, hold up. Hold up. Tommy Armstrong just shrank. Yeah, Tommy Armstrong's 5'5".
He got more tattoos than
go
I saw.
Go to break for that one. That was a big time.
That was not Tommy Armstrong.
Gotcha.
I know he's around town sometimes, but that was not Tommy Armstrong.
Do it to break, Mark. You got to redeem
yourself.
All right,
you listen to the captain here on 93.7 The Team. We'll be right back.
If the week's been too hectic to even think about dinner, or your family can't handle one more night of leftovers, then it's time to let Hog Wild do the cooking. Hog Wild's family packs are one heck of a good deal for a complete barbecue meal loaded with all the smoked meats, tasty sides, buns, and sauces you need to feed your family. Order online at GoHogWild.com. Hog Wild Pit Barbecue, 3210 Cornhusker Highway in Lincoln.
But don't be late, we close at 8. Hi, this is State Senator Carolyn Bozen. Education is a cornerstone to building a strong, vibrant community. I voted for the historic increase in funding for education in the legislature. As a state senator, wife, and mom, I believe Lincoln is a great place to work and raise a family. My husband Reggie and I are local business owners and understand the valuable role of education in our community. This is Carolyn Bozen, and I am asking for your vote on May 14th, paid for by Bozen for Legislature.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
Spring is a time of new beginnings and trying new things. If you haven't tried Fuhrer's Cheese Spread yet, the time is now. For parties for St. Patrick's Day and Easter, or celebrating the NCAA tournament with friends, there's no better dip to bring everyone together and celebrate something from Nebraska. Get to your local grocery store today and load up on Fuhrer's Cheese Spread. No event or party is complete without it on your table. The Double the Savings sales event is happening now through April 22nd at Bonds All Pool and Spa. During this event, buyers can take advantage of up to $1,500 in savings and receive 0% APR for 60 months. Visit the Bonds All Pool and Spa showroom at 33rd and Pioneers or visit their website at bondsallpool.com to learn more about their hot tub sale. Act fast because this offer ends soon. Bonds All Pool and Spa, every day made better.
Rashawn Jackson here for Bauer Infrastructure, a veteran-owned local company proudly serving Lincoln, Lancaster County, and the surrounding areas. Bauer provides quality work at an affordable price, and they're growing rapidly. If you want to experience a career with a fast-paced, family-friendly environment, visit BauerInfrastructure.com. They have top-of-the-line benefits, year-round work, even through the winter. Bauer, usher in the new era of infrastructure to an area near you. And as always, go Big Red!
Clothes dryer not drying like it should? Could be your dryer vent. Call Bryant for a professional cleaning. 467-1111. Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Hi, Sean Callahan here for Copple Chevrolet GMC, and our annual spring sales event is now underway. We have absolutely huge savings right now at Copple. New Sierras and new Silverados have a double whammy. Choose from APR starting at 1.9% or discounts over $9,000. Yes, that's right, 1.9% APR or discounts of over $9,000. So please take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street just south of the interstate, or check us out online at coppelcars.com. You'll be glad you did. All deals with approved credit.
Alcohol has strained our relationship. Drinking too much can cause harm to friends, family members, and loved ones. By drinking less, we will save our relationship. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Do you need motivation to get to the gym on the weekend or even in general? Tune into the Movement Hour each Saturday from 10 to 11 a.m. Movement Academy owner Robert Kuhlman will host the show as he introduces new ways to stay in shape. The Movement Hour, every Saturday morning from 10 to 11 a.m. on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
93.7 The Ticket is proud to provide listeners with daily opportunities to win contests and prizes on our airwaves, and would like to take this opportunity to remind you of a couple rules. All participants must be 21 or older and must wait 30 days after winning a prize before participating in another contest. Once you win, you have 30 days to pick up your prize at the KNTK Studios, 1040 O Street in Lincoln, or your prize will be forfeit. Thank you for participating in our contest, and thank you for listening to 93.7 The Ticket.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Damn. You turn me on.
Come on.
You move me down.
Come on.
You got the rubber to burn.
Come on, Terrell.
You got the bum on me.
Oh, I thought you were going to stay there.
You got the bum.
Why me and Bob's moves? That's how I know I can beat you. Because you just sit there.
That's right. Preserve.
Me and Bob moving around.
Preserve. Track guys don't do all that moving around.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they
do. No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
You was not a 100 meter guy.
Well, I ran 400. You warm up. You warm up, but you don't warm up like
20, 30 minutes.
400 meter guy don't warm up.
Yes, you do. You have to warm up.
Yeah, okay. Anyway.
Anyway, I ran 4x1 too, so I had to warm up too. Whatever.
Don't try to act like you fast. You're still not fast.
Okay, whatever.
Come on, Bob. Give us. This is the last segment. I didn't tell y'all the news just because I don't want to be breaking. I don't want to be the bearer of bad news. How about that?
All right.
I want to stay positive.
There's some bad news you got?
Well, it depends on who you look. Who's looking? Depends on whose side of the street you're on. If I'm on this side of the street and I throw a rock over there and ping you in the head, hey, you're going to be a little upset. Yeah. But now if you're on this side of the street with me, you might be laughing.
Yeah.
Somebody get pinged in the head, don't even know he got pinged by us. You know, he's looking all around trying to figure out where did that rock drop in at. You see what I'm saying? So it just depends on who it is and how you take the information. However you take it, it's good information to have. And we're not going to release it today. Because sometimes we in the media can rush to judgment. Let me say that one more time. Sometimes we in the media can rush to judgment, and then we got to go back and backtrack our words. So instead of me backtracking my words, let me be humble. Let me make sure it's real, right? Mm-hmm. And then I'll say something.
All right.
Okay.
8018 says off the text line, did the black shirt bring any Rasta pasta in? Is barbecuing at the black shirt on YouTube yet?
That's a lie.
I didn't make any Rasta pasta. I didn't find my guy for the pasta. He said he had to make some. So.
Why'd you lie?
Because he had to make some.
Why would you claim you was bringing us Rasta pasta?
Look, didn't I just say the guy didn't have any ready?
So you don't make the Rasta pasta.
I make the pasta, but I don't make the jerk sauce.
Mm. Oh.
So somebody makes the Jamaican jerk sauce.
Somebody make the jerk for you.
Yes.
Okay, I got you. I was just making sure.
How about a busy Board of Regents meeting this Friday where we'll likely learn whether or not they'll move forward with this big project of rebuilding Memorial Stadium? Are you guys still all in on that? I mean, they project $450 million renovation. Others say it could be up to $600 million. Maybe it was a factor in Trev leaving. There's always those kind of thoughts out there. Do you think it's going to move forward, or do you think they're going to put a kibosh on it?
Why wouldn't they put the kibosh on it? Why would we move forward? I don't know. I mean, maybe you can ask the question to the text line, but I don't know. I think at the end of the day, I want to see us win football games. Then we can move forward, right?
Yeah.
Then we can try to figure out how do we make the stadium bigger and better. But me as a fan, I could care less. I don't care how plush those seats are. I don't care. You know how the new movie theaters, they got the plush seats.
Mm-hmm.
Hit the button. You can kick back like you're on the couch.
Oh, yeah, it's nice.
Doesn't matter if you put me in that situation, right?
Mm.
If we lose, it's the same. It's worse. It's worse. Or if we just can go to sleep now. I mean, who cares about that? I think wins and losses is what fans care about. We don't really care about the seats. Now, if you're a fan and you hear me saying this and you feel opposite, please, by all means, hit us up on the text line, 402-464-5685, or you can call us on the telephone at the same number and let me know why.
Yeah, I personally get it. I mean, the NFL stadiums that you go to now, I mean, there's all sorts of different bells and whistles and you know, swimming pools and, you know, who knows what. But I don't know. I think Nebraska is always kind of the focus has been on the game. That's what I like about Nebraska is the focus is on the game. You put all this different stuff there and have beer spots and social settings and all that. It'll be more modern, but it might take away a little bit from just the focus when you're packed in like sardines with 90,000 other people. You might be a little uncomfortable, but the focus is on the game. Mm. And most of the time, that's great. I will admit last year when I went to the Michigan game, that wasn't great, but you know, and that goes back to your point. They got to get a winning product back.
Well. So they're going down to what? 78,000? 80,000?
Yeah,
what?
Yeah, we'll see.
That's one thing I don't like. Keep Memorial Stadium as big as you can get.
Yeah.
You want that because you want the crowd factor. A kid want to say he plays in front of 90,000 people. You know, 78,000 people, you can go to Jacksonville State and probably play in front of that. But at the same time, we want the crowd. You know, just leave it alone. Too much. I mean, you already giving the kids what they want with the new facilities. Just leave the stadium part alone. Mm.
Yeah, I think so. What's going on, Terrell? You all right?
This window.
Get you. I know. Yeah. Don't get distracted by what you see out this window. Very, 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 very distractful. Sorry. Anyway, are you good?
Yeah, you good?
Yeah, I was just making sure you got your statement across.
Yeah, I've been finished.
The way you turned around, you about got whiplash. See how fast he turned around, Box?
That's how fast I'm going to look back at you when I'm beating you. Say, come on, Rashawn. Come on.
You want to hit people with garbage.
Come on.
What else, Box? Is that it?
Got a few thoughts for the text line. Kent says, I'll watch from the bleachers looking through chain link fence to see us win.
See?
Jerry Baum says, get it planned right. I don't like the less seat idea either. David Nebraska says, I still find it ridiculous that they want to tear down South Stadium, which has adequate ramps, and not add adequate ramps to North Stadium. Brad from Baldwin says, if sitting on wooden benches gives us championships, bring on wooden benches. So I think everybody's kind of got
I'll stand up.
Hey, Troy Dannon, is that the athletic director?
Yeah, yeah.
He said, if it's not going to help us win games, then we're probably not going to do it. I love him for that. If that statement alone, I love our athletic director.
Yeah.
For that statement
you
alone.
You should have threw that idea out the window when Trev Albers left. So throw that little take down to 78,000, 80,000, whatever.
We'll
just do that to Texas A&M, Trev. I was not Nebraska. Thank you back. Yeah, send it back to him.
Yes.
Throw the frisbee back.
Throw that boomerang back at him. Huh?
No, thanks.
We don't want your
ideas.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Shoot.
Just trying to mess us up.
And then going to go take all the secrets to Texas A&M in the 12th and 13th.
Let's add 20,000. I took 20 from Nebraska. Let me add 20 to Texas A&M.
Right, that's crazy. What do you got going after this?
DMV.
Yeah, you do, huh?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. What about you?
Well, and you're going to be on the Adam Carriker show.
Yeah.
You ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, for about the first 15
minutes.
You're going
nowhere.
You're going nowhere. First 15 minutes.
You're going to be here.
Oh, no. Yeah,
as the macho man Randy Savage says, oh yeah.
Snap into a Slim Jim.
To the character now. You have been witness of greatness. It's us, the Black Shirt Buck Captain. Oh yeah.
It's like that.
I like that. Oh yeah. Listen, 93.7 on Power.
By
Bauer.
Bauer.
Infrastructure.
Bauer.
I say now underground.
Brand.
Excavated.
Listen, Fast, the 2 hours in radio is over. I apologize if you missed it, but you can go back and catch back up if you did miss it on Twitter, Twitch, all the social media platforms in ILO, right?
Yep.
We'll see y'all tomorrow. Tough Talk Tuesdays. Oh, practice report. Practice report tomorrow. Holla at your boy.
Is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Fern. 93.7 The Ticket.
Spring is here and it's time to wake up Judson. Judson Irrigation is eager and ready to get your sprinkler system up and running for the season. Judson's technicians will check for winter damage, adjust your sprinkler heads, and show you how to set your controller for effective sprinkling coverage. The Judson Irrigation Team is here for you. Stay safe.
Keep summer green. Call Judson Irrigation 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
This is Lancaster County Attorney Pat Condon reminding you to vote for my friend and colleague, Carolyn Bozen. Carolyn Bozen is a strong voice for Lincoln who we need representing us in the legislature. Carolyn Bozen voted for historic